do some electrophysiological data and together with the LADBS folks. This was called the interoptive characterization of functional self-dynamic oscillations and patterns based. As we all know that the subdermic nucleus is a part of the mesoganglia, and it locates normally to the substantia nigra and eventually to the thalamus and medially to the internal capsule. Well, in classic cortex, mesoganglia, thalamus, cortex, movement control system, control network, the ST is the critical nucleus of the inhibitory epidermic pathway and also connected with the motor cortex via the hypodermic pathway. ST is anatomically and functionally connected to the sensory motor network and also associative network, also limbic network. What this makes it as a very key point to stimulate with deeper stimulation, as you all know here. And it was successfully applied in the treating of PD, dystonia, and also in lately in OCD. But from a electrophysiological view, you can know that if we recall signals from the DBS electrode which has been implanted in the skin, we can have this kind of local field potentials. Here, we normally use the bilateral recording to get the LP signals from what we implanted our electrodes. And LP signals contain the pathological and physiological oscillations usually over zero, very low frequency range, up to sometimes nowadays some literature has reported to study in the very high range, high frequency range. The neural oscillations of LP provide direct information of the neural function of the nucleus we can study. In previous study, it shows that the subdermic oscillation contains multiple scale of features. For example, the amplitude of the amplitude of the signal and maybe some phase which I can show it here. Frequency changes like this. In the signal, we have some like low frequencies, beta frequency, gamma, and also high frequency oscillations. And some of the oscillations has been and we have learned that some of the oscillations can be related to medication and also the modulation of the stimulation and some symptoms as well. Previously, we found that, especially in low beta range, when PD patients take medication, we can see a dropped power in this frequency, in this frequency band. And also in some study, we find that the features in local field potential have relationship to the movement. To the progress of the movement, that means it will change, aligned to the time of the cue, to the start of the movement, and also to the stop of the movement. And it also related to the force of the movement, which like the efforts. If we put more efforts to move, or if we squeeze something very hard, the power changes over some frequency can be larger than the situation we put less effort. Also, the modulations can mirror that velocity of the movement as well. If they do it faster, the modulations in the oscillation can occur like earlier than the other situations. And also, it may tell us something about which part of the body is moved. It's moving. Here's some data which has been recorded intraoptically before. What they show is the spectral distribution of the beta oscillation has a like a gradually changing along with the interaction of the DBS electrode. When we reach the dural part of the ST, we can say that some of the oscillation, some of the frequencies, they will have increased the power in the ST range. And also when the electrodes proceed into like the ventral part of ST, some of the power will just go increase. And here is a literature which Andy published before, which he finds out that the oscillations, the different frequency of oscillations may locate in different parts of the ST. For example, what they find is like beta oscillation is mainly located in the sensory motor area, sub area of the ST, while the alpha peak we find is next to the associated part of the ST. As we all know that the resting ST, the resting oscillations inside of ST has widely explored, but what happens to like the functional oscillations, for example, the movement-related oscillations located in the area of ST. So what we done is we recall signal intraoperatively. While patients were asked to hold a handle with a button on top, and he will hear a sound and just press the button as quickly as possible to follow the cueing sound. During this period, it will simultaneously record LP signal from the implanted electrode. So what we want to do is what we want to find that how the movement related oscillations locate across the subthalamic area. That's why we introduce the toolbox, the DBS toolbox, to make it 3D visualize of the STN and the subcortical area. And here's some results. So in this case, we have many patients. Six or seven, maybe. Eight patients. That's fine. So here we show all the electrodes was implanted in the STN area, and what we find is some of the contacts has been located inside of STN, and some of the contacts we found has been located outside of STN, maybe some were also into the membrane part. The next thing we did is we extract the power information from what we recorded from the bipolar channel. And here is an example showed the distribution of the resting and the movement modulated oscillations in one patient. This one is the power spectral density, which we all know we can show the frequency distribution of the oscillations we recorded from the different channel. And from this one, we can see that the channel 1-2, which is the this channel here, which is located in the dorsal part of the STN, it shows the highest beta power, and it's larger than others. Well, the channel here, 2 and 3, which is this one, located outside of STN, it shows the lowest beta power, and actually we cannot find any clear peak in this one. Well, in line with the resting data, we find that what we send a high beta peak, what we find the high beta peak, the channel also showed a largest movement modulation related to the movement button down period.
So how do you normalize your
Well, for this one, because we recall like multiple channels, multiple trials of the movement, so we'll take like 1 second ahead of the start of the movement, ahead of the cube, to be the baseline power. And we will normalize all the power from this time window to the baseline of the power.
Across subject or individual?
Individual. And individual trials, and then we will arrive, we'll average all the normalized trial together to have this kind of figure.
So baseline is calculated from all the subject?
No, the baseline is calculated from each trial of the movement, from each patient.
How many trials have you recorded?
At least, well, what we find is have to be at least 30 to make it, yeah, to make the
stable.
Yeah, yeah, to reject the noise. During the movement, what we find is the, in line with previous study, of course, a increased power in the low frequency range, which mostly located in the alpha range, and a decreased power around beta, both in low beta and high beta frequency, and of course they rebound beta power after the stop of the movement, as well as the increased gamma here, especially the high gamma frequency. And also we find that compared between the low beta frequency and high beta frequency change around the movement, there is a significant difference which can find the which can be found in the power changes across these two subbands. And also in gamma frequency, what we find is when the patient stops the movement, the low gamma frequency will stay still as high in the period of time, but the high gamma oscillation, which is shown like in here, it will just attenuate right on time. And now we want to locate the oscillatory power with the 3D virtualized STN. So what we did is we first normalized the spectral power within the electrodes. That means we will take the power of each frequency points divided by the average the power across all the electrodes. So that means we'll calculate the average power of all three channels, and then use it as a like a kind of baseline or reference to the power on what we calculated. On what channel we calculated. Because we want to find if the power is kind of located in a certain area, or it will be spread as this. So we use Euclidean distance to fulfill this purpose. So we'll calculate this distance between every two contact pairs, that is the every two dots here. And we will compare the variance of this distance between the master group, which contains all the contacts, and a subgroup, which contains only the third of the contact pairs with the highest direct power in the resting state. So in this case, we can show that the red dots are the subgroup of this third of the contact pairs with the highest rank power. So as a result, we can say how the highest power in a certain frequency band located in this sub-thermic area. What we find is that alpha, low beta, and high beta, and gamma oscillation all show the cluster distribution, which is fulfill the statistic test, but not the theta oscillation. But different from what we find in during resting period, or maybe we can show this slides before, here we can see that alpha oscillation may have a more distributed distribution, but during the movement, it becomes located in the ventral part of the STM. And different from what we find in gamma frequency at rest, which the all the high power contacts were found in the dodo part of the STM, but during the movement, it was fine to distribute across the area. So this means that the maybe in STM the pathological or the pathological oscillation in different frequency bands will have a different distribution of quality from the movement related oscillation. So that means the different part of STM may be involved in different kind of function. Maybe some are related to motors, the movement, some are related to like other cognitive processing, or some are related just to the cause of the symptom.
But all your movement is all your fingertips movement, right?
Yeah.
There's no other part of the muscles. So,
actually, the patient was just lying and resting, like
yeah.
Relaxing on the bed.
Yeah.
So,
you concluded this. Motor functions represent both.
I can't actually. But when we did the experiment, we will ask the patient to do not move any part of the body, to just focus on pressing the to listening and press the button of the handle. And because there are multiple trials average, so that it can cancel some of the like occasional movement during this whole recording. So because of the normalized and averaged across trials, we can actually reject some of the induced artifacts from other parts, body parts. In conclusion, that so we find some of the focality of oscillation inside of STN, and this was that the intraoptive FP recorded from the EBS electrode can provide us some like rich source of information which we may be interested in to find a better surgical targeting and maybe to help in the postoperative contact selection, and also maybe in the future to help us to select which kind of contacts can be used as in the closed loop therapy.